Now let us solve the first question in our trigonometry course. So we need to find at least three Pythagorean triples, each number of which is an integer that is greater than 30. When we say Pythagorean triples, I should have three numbers, let's say x, y, z, such that one of these is hypotenuse. Let's say z is the hypotenuse. So z square equal to x square plus y square. That is, these three numbers should satisfy Pythagoras' theorem. So how to find this? How to find Pythagorean triples? One strategy is to use trial and error method. Let's say I can take x equal to 3, y equal to 4, and z equal to 5. So z square is equal to 5 square equal to 25. X square equal to 3 square equal to 9, y square equal to 4 square equal to 16. So it satisfies the condition z square equal to x square plus y square, which is 25 equal to 9 plus 16. So 3, 4, 5, it forms a Pythagorean triple. However, we have a restriction here that the numbers should be integers, that is x, y, z should be integers which are greater than 30. So you cannot take 3 or 4 or 5. So we need to think of numbers which are greater than 30. So how to get these numbers? Of course, there is a simple idea to arrive at Pythagorean triples. Let's say a, b, c form Pythagorean triple. Here c square equal to a square plus b square. Now you can write a equal to m square minus n square, b equal to 2mn, and c equal to m square plus n square, where m and n are integers. You can use any integer and follow these rules to form a Pythagorean triple. For instance, if I could take m equal to 3 and n equal to 2, let's say. So a is equal to 3 square minus 2 square, which is 9 minus 4 equal to 5. B equal to 2mn, so 2 into 3 into 2, which is 12. C equal to m square plus n square, which is 3 square plus 2 square, which is equal to 13. So if you notice, the Pythagorean triple here is 5, 12, 13. So if you want to verify, you can always verify 5 square plus 12 square is equal to 25 plus 144, which is equal to 169, which is nothing but your 13 square. So this method works. So one of the sides of triangle, you can assume, let's say this is the right angle triangle. And this is A, this is B, and this is C. So where A is nothing but m square minus n square, and B is 2mn, then C is definitely m square plus n square. So this formula or this idea you can use to form Pythagorean triples. And this is what we have done to arrive at three Pythagorean triples. Let's see one by one. So this is what we have discussed. So to find triples, we can use the formula a equal to m square minus n square, b equal to 2mn, and c equal to m square plus n square. So possible triples, and the condition given here is abc should be greater than 30. So I'm manipulating the value of m and n in such a way that a, b, and c, it becomes greater than 30. Here m is equal to 7. And n equal to 4, it yields a equal to 33, b equal to 56, and c equal to 65. So 33, 56, and 65, it forms a Pythagorean triple. So you can verify. So it's been verified here. Similarly, you can form other two triples as well, because the question asks for three Pythagorean triples. Now the second question. The question is, if the base and height of a right triangle are equal, this is the given data, we need to find the relation between hypotenuse and the base. So let's say this is the right triangle. So this is A, B and C. This is our base. And this is the height. And this is our hypotenuse. So it's given base and height of right triangle are equal. Therefore, AB is equal to BC. We need to find the relationship between hypotenuse and the base, that is between AC and BC. So by Pythagoras theorem, we know hypotenuse square is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. So therefore, AC square equal to AB square plus BC square. Since AB equal to BC, find the relationship between hypotenuse and base. We can write AB square plus BC square as 2 times of BC square, because AB is equal to BC. So AC square equal to 2 BC square. Taking square roots, we get AC equal to root 2 BC. So this is the relationship between hypotenuse and base in a right triangle, where base and height of the right triangle are equal. So this is what we have given in our worksheet solution as well. So hypotenuse square equal to base square plus height square. So hypotenuse square can also be written as base square plus base square, because height is equal to base, that's the given data. So it is 2 times of base square. So hypotenuse is root 2 times of base. So it is also true that hypotenuse is root 2 times of height, because base and height are one and the same. So now the third question. We need to check whether the following measurements, that is these measurements of a triangle, correspond to that of a right triangle. If so, we need to identify which one is the hypotenuse. So there are basically two questions in it. We need to check if it is a right triangle and which one is the hypotenuse if right triangle is true. So this is fairly easier one, because the dimension with greater value will be the hypotenuse, because hypotenuse is the longer side in a right triangle. However, before that, we need to confirm that the given dimensions form a right triangle. So how to do that? We can use Pythagoras theorem here. As per Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square equal to sum of squares of other two sides. So if the given dimension form a right triangle, then hypotenuse is the greater side. So let us say 10 is the hypotenuse here. So 10 square is 100. Now sum of squares of other two sides is 6 square plus 8 square, which is equal to 36 plus 64 equal to 100. So this implies 10 square equal to 6 square plus 8 square, which is true. And hence this triple 10, 6, 8, it forms a right triangle. So it is true that it is a right triangle. And which one is the hypotenuse? Obviously, 10 centimeter is the hypotenuse, because that is the longer side in this triangle. So we are going to use the same methodology to solve other triples in this question. So this is what we said. Hypotenuse is 10 centimeter. And this is also true. So this had been verified here. So 10, 6, 8 are measurements of a right triangle. Whether 20, 7 and 8, it forms a right triangle. So hypotenuse, if I am assuming that this is a right triangle, hypotenuse is 20 centimeter, and 7 square plus 8 square should be equal to, sorry, there is a typo error here, this should be 20 square. So if this is true, then this is a right triangle. However, 7 square plus 8 square is 113, which is not equal to 20 square. and hence 20, 7, 8 doesn't form a right triangle. Similarly, 12, 5, 17, so 12 square plus 5 square, it yields 169, which is not equal to 17 square. And hence 12, 5, 17 doesn't form a right triangle. So you can solve such problems using Pythagoras theorem. So question number 4, we need to find the value of x in the relationships given here, 3 square plus x equal to 5 square. So this fairly straightforward. So what we need to do is 9 plus x equal to 25. So x is equal to 16. So this simple algebra, that's what you need to use to solve the problems of this type. So that's what we have done here. X is equal to 5 square minus 3 square equal to 16. Similarly, 24 square plus x square equal to 25 square. So we can find x square is 49. So x is equal to 7. Actually, this should be x is equal to plus or minus 7. However, we are talking in terms of Pythagoras theorem. You can notice that this is sum of squares of two sides and this is equal to hypotenuse square. So this is in context of triangles and trigonometry. So we generally tend to ignore x equal to minus 7. Simple reason is there is no side with a negative value. So going forward, next question. So root 3 x square plus 25 equal to 34. So we can write root 3 x square as root 3 times of x plus 25 equal to 34 and root 3 times of x equal to 9. So x is equal to 9 by root 3, which is 9 by root 3 is nothing but 3 into 3 by root 3. So 3 and 3 I can cancel. So 3 root 3. So similarly, you can solve the next problem. X square plus 9 square. So you would get x equal to 40. So question number 5. We need to find the height of an isosceles triangle, equal sides of which are a centimeter. So we need a isosceles triangle. So assume this to be an isosceles triangle, A, B and C. So isosceles triangle means any two sides of the triangle are equal, and in this case let us say AB is equal to AC. Equal sides of which are a centimeter. So this is A, this is A, and the base is B centimeter. So now we need to find the height of this isosceles triangle. So let us first understand what exactly is the height of a triangle. What's the property the height of the triangle possesses? Height of triangle is nothing but a perpendicular line that is drawn from one of the vertex, in this case A, to the opposite side, in this case BC. So let me call this as D. AD is perpendicular to BC. And AD is the height as well. So if you notice, this particular height or AD divides ABC into two congruent triangles. That is ABD, which is congruent triangle ADC. How it is congruent? AD is common to both the triangles. And one of the angles, that is angle ADB, is equal to angle ADC because both are 90 degree. And of course, AB is equal to AC because this is given that it is an isosceles triangle with side a centimeter. So it is a congruent triangle. With this congruency idea, we are going to find the height AD of this triangle. Let's see how we have done this. So this is what we said. So AB a centimeter, AC a centimeter, BC b centimeter. So we can use Pythagoras theorem because ADC is a right angle triangle. So using Pythagoras theorem, this is Pythagoras. So this is a right angle. Using Pythagoras theorem, we will get AD square plus BC by 2 the whole square is equal to AC square. Why BC by 2 the whole square? Because since these two triangles are congruent, BD is equal to DC. However, BC is equal to BD plus DC. So therefore, BC is equal to 2DC or DC is equal to BC by 2. And hence, we have written in place of DC square, we have written BC by 2 the whole square. So AD is our height. So AD square equal to AC square minus BC square by 4. And here AC is nothing but A, and hence A square minus BC is nothing but B square by 4, which is 4A square minus B square by 4. Taking square root on both sides, we would get AD is equal to square root of 4A square minus B square by 2, because root of 4 is 2. So this is the required answer.